Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform recording actions in JMeter. So to perform the recording, we need to follow certain number of steps. So first thing is we need to add non-test element. Then we need to set proxy and browser, either Chrome or Firefox. Then we need to start recording on different scenarios using recording controller. Then we need to stop scenario recording and finally stop recording and save it. So we'll see step by step. So the first step, we need to create a non-test element. And before that, I need to add some thread group here. Let me add thread. And this is a thread group I have added. Under this, I'm just going to create, under plan, I'm just going to create one non-test element. So this is the first step. So here, take HTTPS test script recorder. So just I'm taking this. Now here, you can find target controller. So here there are a list of target controllers will be there. So here HTTPS test script recorder is a default recorder which is there here. So what I can do is I can just create a different type of controllers here. Recording controller especially I will create here. And under those recording controllers, I'll just generate the script. I'll record the script. And one more thing here is there is a port number. So this port number we have to set as a proxy port number to your browser. So then JMeter can easily get all the statements which are those requests basically sending to the server will be captured. So this port number is very, very important. So next one is, so once you created your thread group and then we have created a script recorder. So instead of getting the all the requests inside this particular test script recorder, I'm just going to create one more controller called recording controller. So here right click on thread group and I'm going to add logic controller and then select here a recording controller. So I'm just creating one recording controller and here I will just record the opening the login page. So this is first recording controller I'm creating. And the next one is I will create one more recording controller. Just go to add and logic controller and then go to recording controller. And here I will create, I will generate the script for a registration page, right? So registration process, login page and registration. So once you created these two controllers, these are all recording controllers. Now inside this, we will create a script or we have to record the script. So once we created these two recorded controllers and then go to again back to test script recorder. So here we have a port number. So with this port number, we have to create a proxy to your browser. So we need to change the proxy settings. Now we'll go back to the steps. So first we have added non-test element, which is HTTP recording. And next step is we need to set proxy on the browser. After setting the proxy on the browser, then we need to start the recording. So what I'm going to record here is first I will open the basic web page. So here I have an application called Mercury Tools application. So I'm just going to open this application. So that's a home page I'm going to open. So just open this one. And here this application home page. So this particular page I'm going to open. This is the first action I'm going to do. And after that, I'm just trying to click on register. Now it will take some time to get the registration page. And after that, I'll perform the registration, then click on the submit. So these actions, two actions. One is opening the home page, then clicking on the register and get the data, provide the data to the server. So perform the registration process. So these two requests I'm going to record. So to do this, first step, we need to set a browser proxy. So how we can do that? So to do this, open your Chrome browser. And in the Chrome browser, we need to go to settings. Under settings, we need to just go to advanced. Under advanced, you just go to again system. Under system, you can see open proxy settings. So once you open this proxy settings, you will see one more window like this. And here you need to just click on LAN settings. And here, check this option. So use a proxy server for your LAN. So select this one and provide your address from where JMeter is running. So this is your local host. Currently my JMeter is running on my local host. This is a port number which should exactly match in your JMeter. So now JMeter will recognize all the requests which are sending through browser. And the steps will be recorded in this controller. So now let us set this option. So currently I say localhost and this is the port number, then okay, and then okay. So now we need to, we have set browser proxy and then close the browser. So as soon as we started, as soon as we specify this proxy on browser, then we need to start recording different scenarios. One is homepage, launching the homepage and perform the registration. So after recording these two scenarios, I'll just stop the recording. So let's go to JMeter again. So now if I go and see this test script recorder here, start button is enabled, right? And also in the target controller, now we can see login page and registration. These two recorded controllers we already added under thread group. So login page, launching the login page will be part of, I will record that script under login page. And registration process, I will record under registration controller. So what I can do is currently I'm checking this one, login page. And here, HTTP sampler settings, so prefix and transaction name will be there. So you can just give some name here. Let's say login page. I'm just giving some login page and just say 2000 milliseconds. Just give some name. So after providing some information here, just click on start. So once you click on the start, it will ask you to agree the agreement. So certificate agreement, it will ask. So we need to just confirm okay. And once it is confirmation is okay, then it is started recording. So the currently the new window will be open like this. So now we can start our recording. As soon as we started our recording, then we click on the stop button. So now currently login page recorded controller is selected here. So now I'm performing the login. So let me open the browser. And after that, I'm launching my homepage. So I'm just adding this URL and press enter. And this will launch your URL. So till here, the first scenario, I copied. So after that, just stop the recording. So once I have stopped the recording, now we can go to the JMeter and see the login page recorded controller. You can see a lot of actions are generated here, right? So these are actions are generated. These are different requests sent to the server while launching your login page. And similarly, I will also record the requests which are performing the registration process. Now again, go to the test script recorder. And then again, this time I'll change this as a registration page. Registration page. Now again, start recording. So I'm just clicking on start recording. Now before that, what I can do is I can just select, I'm just stopping it. So before that, what I should do is I need to select registration, because the script we are going to record under registration. So just let me select the registration this time and then click on the start. So once we have started, again it asks the agreement, just click on okay, then record is started. So now we need to launch the browser. Already URL is launched. Now I'm clicking on register. After clicking on the register, so it will launch the registration page. Now I can just enter some data here, but these data or recording will not be recorded. Only the transactions between the client and server request will be recorded. Request and responses will be recorded because this is a performance testing. So not a functional testing. So here I'm just adding some data and I'll say some email ID, then some address or something and some city, then state, and after that some PIN code number and then something and username and password and password, then click on the submit. So till here I have recorded. So let's wait for completion of all the page and then click on the stop recording. So then after completion of the recording, now you can see under registration recorded control also you can see a lot of requests. So now I have recorded all the script for login page and also registration page along with the registration transaction. So once we recorded is done, so we need to again make our proxy settings back. So because the JMeter, we already set the proxy and which is running on this particular port number. And after completion of recording, we need to again make back the all the default settings. So let's go to your Chrome browser, again go to settings. Now in the settings, just go to advanced again, and here you can see system, go to proxy settings, and here go to LAN settings and just uncheck this option. So only at the time of recording, you need to enable this option. Okay, then okay, then close the browser. So everything is done back. Fine, so this is how we need to record the script in JMeter. So once we have recorded this script, so now currently I have login page, this is recording controller. and this is another controller. So we can also execute this one. So if you want to execute, so what I can do is I can also add some kind of listener report. I'm just adding listener, and here I'll say view results tree I'm adding. So then save this and execute. So once I have started execution, now we can see results in result view results window. So there are some requests are failing here. So sometimes the server is not properly responded, then these requests will be failed. So now we can see response code is 404. All the failures, response code is different. So we can see some of them are passed and some of them are failed. So you can see here, so all the requests from 18 to almost 35, right? So here 18 to 19, here 29 to 35. So all the requests have been executed. And some of them are a failure because of server is not properly responding sometimes. So there are some failures also there. So this is how we need to just record the transactions, whatever we have done in the web pages, by enabling our proxy. After recorded all the steps, then JMeter capture all the requests. And once we have done all the recording process, then just disable our proxy. And because we can just make the default proxy settings for the browser, and then everything is fine. So now we can execute all these requests in JMeter. So that's all we need to perform the recording in JMeter. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.